Everyone, I'm Annie Dans, independent journalist, shining light on police and policy issues in Western North Carolina. I have a Substack newsletter called Cops in Congress. If you haven't already, please subscribe, anniedans.substack.com. I am an independent journalist, and I rely on your help and support. So if you feel the able to, if you're able to contribute, please do so. I have a Buy Me a Coffee link to support my work. My latest article is very troubling. Motorcyclist is dead after eluding police. Community questions the pursuit policy. I have just published this and want to share some thoughts and read it for those who may not be able to readily read an article. Maybe you're traveling, maybe you're driving in the car, so please drive safely. Motorcyclist is dead after eluding police. Community questions pursue policy. John Karl Garner Jr., 36, died in Rutherfordton on Wednesday, yesterday. The Rutherford County Sheriff's Office was in pursuit of him on a motorcycle, the North Carolina Highway Patrol said. This is a photo of him from Facebook, giving the middle finger, sitting on a motorcycle. Rutherford County Sheriff's Office deputies chased a motorcyclist from at least US 64-74A, known as Chimney Rock Road, through Green Hill into downtown Rutherfordton, then further south on US 221 on Wednesday, according to multiple witnesses. It is unclear at this time where exactly and why the pursuit was initiated. The motorcyclist, John Carl Garner Jr., 36, died. Sheriff James Aaron Ellenberg told me more information is expected to be released this afternoon. On Wednesday, December 20th, at approximately 4 p.m., the North Carolina State Highway Patrol, known as NCSHP, responded to a collision involving a fatality on US 221 South, just south of Rutherfordton. The initial investigation revealed that a motorcycle traveled through a steady red light at a high rate of speed at the intersection of US 221 and Poors Ford Road and collided with a Nissan Murano passenger vehicle. Chris Knox, first sergeant of the NCSHP Public Information Office, said in an email to Cops in Congress. That was earlier today. The motorcycle came to rest in the intersection, and the passenger vehicle came to rest on the shoulder of Poors Ford Road just outside of the intersection. The driver of the motorcycle was ejected and came to rest in the intersection near the motorcycle. The driver of the motorcycle, John Garner Jr. of Chesney, South Carolina, was pronounced deceased at the scene. At the time of the collision, the Rutherford County Sheriff's Office was engaged in a pursuit of the motorcycle. The State Highway Patrol did not have any involvement in the pursuit, he said. Biker down, doing CPR, check on your people, a witness, Micah Mills, said in a local Meta Facebook group. I want to share the Facebook page for a moment because there's no guarantee that this will remain posted. Micah Mills is, of course, free to do what he wishes with this post. This is a great community group. It has almost 25,000 members, Rutherfordton, Far City, and Spindale Town Talk. And in that, Micah Mills was witnessing the event. And in some of the comments, there's many comments, there's 238 comments to be exact, it has been shared 67 times. Now I'm going to continue reading my article to get into some further detail. That bike passed me going close to 100 miles per hour on 6474 past Green Hill toward Rutherfordton. Came within a foot of my car when passing, with one cop behind him and another then joined the chase. Biker knew exactly what he was doing, and I just hope nobody else was hurt. Cops risk their lives every day to stop these, yes, criminals. If they let them go, it would just happen more often. Condolences to his family. He should have just pulled over and respect authority, and he would still be alive, Jen Dittmer Bivolo said in that group. I was run off the road in Edward Street with this chase. I cannot foresee there being anything at all to put that many citizens at risk, especially with the 10 to 15 officers it seemed were chasing him, said Michelle, Heather, and Tony. Community questions high-speed police pursuits. In North Carolina, there are no statewide laws that set police pursuit policies. It is left up to each individual law enforcement agency. The state's top traffic agency, the North Carolina State Highway Patrol, has seen a dramatic increase in chases. Last year, they engaged in more than 1,000 pursuits, a 132% increase from 2019, ABC 11 reported in June. And these hyperlinks are throughout the article. Please check them out. The popular television show On Patrol Live regularly features the Brookford Police Department with several motorcycle pursuits in Catawba County near Hickory. A Hickory Police Department officer was fired after a woman and her son died as he pursued a motorcycle earlier this year. Again, please check out those hyperlinks. Cops shouldn't chase bikes for this exact reason. There should be a no pursuit law. Get the tag info and go from there, Brendan Bede said in that Facebook group. RCSO would change a plane, LMAO. They go through more cars than any other LEO, law enforcement organization, you know what Herring said. I mean this in the most respectful way, but just because it's a bike doesn't mean they shouldn't be obeying the law. You would be amazed at how many drugs come through our county due to bikes. They need to obey the law just like someone driving a car, and just because they're on a bike doesn't mean they should be let go. They shouldn't be running from our officers in the first place, Meredith Odell said. Her boyfriend is RCSO Sergeant Joseph McComas. This is a horrible tragedy. My heart goes out to the family of the man killed. I also feel horrible for the officer that was pursuing him. He or she was doing their job. No officer wants to chase anyone, Bruce Malloy said. Cops in Congress does not see a pursuit policy available publicly on the Rutherford County Sheriff's Office website, unlike other Western North Carolina law enforcement agencies such as Charlotte, Hickory, and Asheville. Again, check out those hyperlinks. A public records request is pending with the Rutherford County Sheriff's Office and Rutherford County Government. It was emailed earlier today. A Department of Justice report published by the Police Executive Research Forum recommends that, quote, pursuits should take place only when two very specific standards are met. One, a violent crime has been committed, and two, the suspect poses an imminent threat to commit another violent crime, end quote. The report recommends policies that discourage or prohibit pursuits if the suspect is riding a motorcycle. North Carolina's run and you're done law. You're required by law to safely come to a complete stop when police sirens appear behind you, signaling you to pull over. If you fail to stop as required by traffic police performing their duties, you can face serious charges in North Carolina, according to King Law Firm. Passed in 2011, the Run and You're Done law was intended to outlaw fleeing from the police to stop them from carrying out their duties. Law enforcement can seize vehicles under the statute. In certain parts of the state, they're seizing vehicles by utilizing drones and other technology, such as in Fayetteville. Again, check out those hyperlinks. Why did John Garner do what he did? Garner had a lengthy criminal history dating back to 2004 per state records. He was released from prison in 2022 following a plea deal in Raleigh. He was facing numerous charges in Polk County at the time of his death, according to court records, including multiple felonies, a flee, evade arrest, possess stolen vehicle, possession with intent to sell or deliver marijuana, cruelty to animals, and possession of firearm by felon with ultra-remove gun serial number. You're welcome to check out those hyperlinks for more information and these screenshots from the court website. Here's some commentary, Cops in Congress commentary. I work to shine a light on police and policy issues. People may choose to run from the police for various reasons, and it's important to note that individuals' motivations can differ widely. Some common reasons include 1, fear of consequences. Individuals may run because they are afraid of facing legal consequences for their actions. This could involve pending arrest warrants, outstanding fines, or other legal issues. 2, panic. In some situations, people may act impulsively out of panic or anxiety when confronted by law enforcement. Fear and stress can lead to irrational decisions. 3, guilt or shame. Individuals who have committed a crime or are engaging in legal activities may run to avoid being caught and facing the consequences of their actions. 4, misunderstanding. In certain cases, people may run from the police due to understanding or belief that they are being pursued for something they did not do. 5, prior negative experiences. Some individuals may have had negative experiences with law enforcement in the past, leading to a lack of trust. This mistrust can contribute to a decision to flee from the police. 6, desperation. Individuals facing desperate situations, such as financial struggles or personal crises, may run to as a last resort to avoid perceived negative outcomes. It's important to emphasize that running from the police is illegal and can lead to more serious charges. Law enforcement is trained to handle various situations, and fleeing can escalate the level of response and risk involved. Individuals should cooperate with law enforcement and address legal issues through proper channels, but it is your right to question everything and record everything under the U.S. Constitution. North Carolina is a one-party consent state. State Senator Tim Moffitt, who covers Rutherford County, tried to change that with SB 367. I told lawmakers why they shouldn't change it, and they didn't. North Carolina journalists agree. Citizens have the right to record interactions with police. Further protections were granted this year in North Carolina, South Carolina, Maryland, and Virginia. Live streaming police during a traffic stop is protected speech, according to the Fourth Circuit. Again, Cops in Congress by Annie Dance is a service journalism newsletter focusing on policy, police, and public records in the Lake Lure, North Carolina area. It is free to read, but it is not free to produce. Please click on the button below to support my work. That will bring you to my buymeacoffee.com/AnnieMDance link, where you can buy me a virtual coffee or buy me a gallon of gas. Your support is greatly appreciated. You, the readers, listeners, the donors, make my independent, community-supported public service journalism possible. Please help keep this newsletter free. Keep my work going. It is vitally important. Again, virtually buy me a coffee or gallon of gas to help me inform you by covering the important issues of Rutherfordton, Lake Lure, and Western North Carolina. You can donate on that link. For further inquiries, including tips, suggestions, in-kind support, or sponsorships, please email me, copsandcongress@gmail.com. That's copsandcongress@gmail.com. And you can, of course, follow me on X, formerly known as Twitter, Facebook, LinkedIn, Instagram, TikTok, and YouTube. I tend to use my Facebook page the most and Twitter, but I'm available on all of those platforms. And you can click throughout the hyperlinks to learn more about my newsletter and my background. Briefly, I'll just say I'm a deaf independent journalist. I am mostly deaf. I'm based in the Green Hill area of Rutherford County. And currently, as of today, Thursday, December 21st, 2023, Rutherford County remains a split congressional district covered by 2 congressional districts, the 11th and the 10th. And I go into further detail on my welcome page about that, but it is changing to the 14th. So stay tuned for further news about that. But some ways the cops and Congress interact and overlap are really interesting. And I want to briefly summarize this. Cops refers to law enforcement officers who work for police departments at the local, state, or federal level. Congress refers to the legislative branch, of the United States government, which is responsible for creating and passing laws at the federal level. As time and funding permit, I also aim to cover local and state issues. Why are certain laws created? Who makes our laws? Who enforces them? What happens when there is limited or no oversight? How are taxpayers impacted? Again, please feel free to visit anniedance.substack.com to learn more. And finally, briefly, let me go through these comments where I initially saw the tip about this incident. Now, John Garner, I encourage any of his friends or family members, if I'm sure they may be upset with my reporting, I don't apologize for covering this important issue because it speaks not only to him, but to a larger issue of police pursuits. And I think that's an issue that obviously remains to be a hot topic among the community, and more to come on that. So in the comments, there's, as I stated in my reporting, there are many, and I highlighted just a few of those, but I encourage you to scroll through and you can view more of them. And I'm doing this for archival purposes to quickly go through all of them as a way to capture that. And one that I did not include for just for sheer length in my article was from a gentleman, Jonathan Edward Zafuto, who indicated, "Unfortunately, I pulled up as it happened. I saw a big puff of black smoke and flames. There were police all around. Then I saw an individual on the ground with what looked like work boots on. There was a blonde woman in a brown outfit giving CPR for what looked like 5 minutes, until a gentleman jumped in to give her rest. As I looked around, the bike, unfortunately, was unrecognizable. It looked gray, but there was fire next to it burning. Something looked like possibly a seat. The guy gave way back to the blonde, and she proceeded CPR again. By that time, more emergency vehicles showed up and kind of blocked the scene. I spoke with a friend that was working in traffic, and she said he didn't make it. She and I thought he had just crashed because we didn't see any other vehicles involved until I pulled away. I saw the biker hit the front driver's seat side tire of a red, I believe, Subaru. I promised I was praying the whole time when I was watching this, hoping to see this young man's leg move. Please pray for his family, please." And then the original author, Micah Mills, wrote, "I pulled up right after two, but didn't see it happen. The red car was pulling over when I pulled up and then saw the woman talking to police before she started. It gave me cold chills." And they continue. I think it's important to note that there was some discussion as, you know, why would you post this sort of thing? I think in such a small community like ours, it's information like this is critical to know about for various reasons, as I've explained. And because covering police and public records, for me, it isn't easy. And I don't say that lightly. It's something I feel like I need to do. I've been covering police for a very long time. I was in college on 9/11 in New York City, so I got my start covering police then, in the wake of 9/11, of the events at the World Trade Center in New York. But locally, public records are essential to understand what is going on in your community. And it's important when it's a small community, it's a small police force. They can't possibly tell us every possible thing that they're doing. So this is a way to bridge the gap. Social media is a way for us to know about what's going on with some citizen journalism like this gentleman and more official journalism like me. Because in this area of Western North Carolina, nestled between Charlotte and Asheville, it really is a news desert, and I'm working to bridge that gap. And there were some comments about me asking for photos. And I just want to be clear that I was asking for a photo of the deceased at a happier time in his life. And then you have lighter news, like this person asking if Santa will be at Pops in Far City on Friday night or just Saturday night. So there's, again, there's a way to bridge that gap, and hopefully that shines some more light on this situation. Please visit anniedance.substack.com. Thank you so much. Have a great day.